Do you know what today is? Today is legacy. Today, legacies are made. Do you know what this is? This is a symbol of a legacy. Do you also know what this weekend is? Memorial Day weekend. I was a Boy Scout of America, which makes me one of the greats. My brother was a captain. His partner was in the army. And my ex-girlfriend was in the Air Force? Anyway, tonight, I'm gonna make my legacy because I am the Eagle of Justice. This stands for freedom, for greatness, for most of all, justice. So when I walk out WAW champion and gold is back around at Zarrello's waist, sorry if my brother's jealous, the Eagle of Justice will soar high, perched on WAW.
Legacy 2007, once again, Dirty Dealer on his way to the top. I've been the champion many times, I've made a champion many times. You know what Legacy 07 is? Another notch on the bed of what Dirty Dealer has done from the backside in WAW. Tonight, I take Joey Staplez to the top. Once again, Dirty Dealer, gonna be known as the greatest not only performer ever, but the greatest manager in WAW history. Right. It's all you, baby, tonight. All you.
It's gonna be all me, but you know what? I'm dedicating tonight. It's my boy Tupac, of course. You know, he's up in heaven there with that kid Jake, you know?
I like Biggie.
Hey, that's fine with you. And also dedicate this to Danger. He was also hanging out with Rob Marsh. Well, they're in the penal system now, but...
Yeah, man, I brought him cookies last week. It was good. Yeah,
that was good. But tonight, Katie Dube, don't get in my way. I'll wreck you like I've wrecked you the last 2 weeks. You got lucky this past week. Lucky! Let me get ready for this match.
All right, man, let's go do this. Dirty Dealer, payback, go!
Legacy. Just speaking its name conjures up some very memorable moments. F.O. unlocking Ivana and finally freeing her from Q's puppy-kicking ways. Major Morenci forming Full Metal Jacket and becoming the only two-time Lumberyard winner. Sin, Gino, and K-Man crashing through simultaneous tables at Cemetery Gate 666. Asylum, The Kindred, and Total Chaos putting in one of the best tag team matches of all time. And me, Freakin Flax, beating Todd Sople in a best of five matches and becoming the WAW champion. Not only was I on top of my buddy's shoulders, but I was on top of the world. I love being the WAW champion. I embodied all that was good and fun in WAW, and I went out there each and every night and tried my best to defend that title any chance that I got. And then came the hiatus. And all I was hearing for 6 months was about how I was a joke champion because we weren't wrestling. Well, legacy to legacy would have been a great, great time period to hold my title. 378 days is how long I was champion, the longest in WAW history. And when I lost it just 3 weeks before, I'll admit it, I wept. I cried like a little goat. But then when I heard it was being defended in the Lumberyard match, I got excited. Not only in pants, not only in my head, but in my goatee. Because I knew I was going to be main eventing Legacy. And tonight, I'm an angry goat, and I'm going to go up there, and I'm going to serve up a buffet of tossed salads, the likes of which you've never seen. Up through the anal cavity, through the body, and out the mouth. And you know what you're going to taste? Defeat. Or what I had for lunch earlier. I mean, horseradishes and leprechaun piss is a deadly combination. But tonight is also about Jake. And I hope you're watching from that big beer pong game in the sky. Because we're gonna do it for you, brother.
Come on, man.
Hey, come on, you guys all right? Yeah. Hey, man, tough loss. I'm sorry about that. But hey, I'm kicking it old school tonight, all right? I got a joke for you. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Ray.
Ray, who?
Raise up, bitch!
Raise up, bitch?
All right, let's go get that chicken, man.
Tonight, not only am I defending my legacy championship, but I'm also in the ring with five other contenders for the WAW title. You see, if anyone knows anything about mythology, before a phoenix can die and rise from the ashes, it loses all its feathers, it loses all of its beauty, only to emerge the very next day as a brand new being. Tomorrow, when I wake up, sure, I'll have no hair, but I'll have a title around my waist. And not only am I going to be the new WAW champion and two-time legacy champion, but I go on to annihilation next year to kick my own ass. Skyler Phoenix, you better start getting ready, cause I'm coming for that title!
Instead of you at Legacy.
You know what? You better add me to that funeral. Because I know a thing or two about threesomes, and I'm taking my rematch for the title at Legacy in a threesome. Olé, you bald-headed son of a bitch!
Zarrello makes his way towards the ring, and we are going to do things a little bit differently this year. We are going to have all six participants start things out here in this lumberyard match. Before starting the contest, where it will be all six participants in a free-for-all for the Legacy Championship and for the vacant WAW Championship. And now we await the arrival of entrant number two. Oh God, time for cover. Oh, he's firing a gun. Oh wait, it's just Joey Staplez making his way out to the ring here at number two. Got himself on a little new intro to his theme song. I thought somebody was firing a gun. Given the neighborhood that we hold these shows in, I wouldn't be surprised. Joey Staplez entering as the second participant here in the Lumberyard match. Entry number really has nothing to do with your odds to win. Joey Staplez coming out here, our second participant out of six. Let's find out who our next participant is going to be.
Give him the belt now.
Here comes the man who just 1 year ago was defending the WAW Championship here at Legacy, but this year is now competing for the vacant WAW Championship. The former one-time WAW Champion and leader of the Emerald Embassy, it is the Equalizer, Todd Sople, giving that belt a look as he makes his way into the ring for Legacy 2007. Already having quite the successful night on the managing end, looking to double it up in the wrestling end. Let's find out who's coming out next. Comes somebody making a bit of history here tonight at Legacy. It is Katie Dube, the female phenomenon. She becomes the first female to ever main event a Legacy. There's been six of them, and Katie has broken the standard here tonight of no females in the main event. Our first female ever is here to try and win the WAW Championship. Our final two entrants are going to be Freakin Flax and Scarlet Phoenix. Let's see who comes out next.
And mashed potatoes and corn and lima beans and salad. Come on, get in the kitchen,
Newbie.
Entering first and hailing from Montezuma, Georgia, is the goat with the most, Freakin Flax.
And Freakin Flax gonna take it retro tonight, making his way out to raise up the classic theme song that he sported from summer of 2004 all the way up until Apocalypse 2006. What the hell has he got? Freakin Flax is riding a scooter all the way into Legacy 2007, where he will attempt to win back the WAW Championship, a title that he lost 3 weeks ago. He looks to win back here tonight, and Freakin Flax rides in style into Legacy 2007.
Entering sixth and last, hailing from Phoenix, Arizona, the defending Legacy Champion, the unbreakable Skyy.
And here comes our last entrant into the Lumberyard match, the defending Legacy Champion, as it is said, the unbreakable Skyler Phoenix, coming out the change of seasons, rise of the Phoenix. Here he comes, Skyler Phoenix, heavily favored in the WWWrestling.com forums to walk out of here tonight, the WWE Champion, but he has got some stiff competition in the five other competitors here tonight as we get ready to determine a Legacy Champion and a brand new WAW Champion. We're about to get underway, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go. You've seen five matches thus far. Here's the sixth and final match of the evening, the fourth annual Lumberyard match. Triple Irish whip by Sople, Staplez, Zarrello. Duck by Flax, Phoenix, Dube. Another duck and a flying clothesline by Flax, Phoenix, and Dube, taking Sople, Staplez, and Zarrello out of the ring. And that's one hell of a tongue twister if I've ever seen one. Sople, Staplez, Zarrello. Try saying that 10 times fast. And we got a three-person dropkick there, sending Zarrello, Sople, and Staplez to the floor. And we got flipping clutches by Phoenix, Flax, and Dube. taking out their adversaries here in this match. Everybody's an adversary here in this one. It's the fourth annual WAW match. It's for the Legacy Championship. It's for the Vacant WAW Championship. And Freakin Flax has got the Figure Flax modified on Saige Zarrello. I think Zarrello's legs were a little too big for Flax's, so he modified it with an arm across the leg. Wait a second, Joey Staplez tries to clothesline from Southie! And he takes Katie Dube down. She looked like she was folded in half. Catapulted into the ring apron there by Saige Zarrello on Freakin Flax. And now Joey Staplez is bringing the lumber into the ring already. Follow the leader on the floor by Freakin Flax. Excuse me, by Saige Zarrello on Freakin Flax. Sople choking away at Skyler Phoenix on the floor as Joey Staplez sets up a table in the ring. He is wasting no time here in this lumberyard match in setting up the lumber. And what is he going to do to the female phenomenon, Katie Dube? Setting her up for a powerbomb. Could be time to go through the wood. She tries fighting with a Hurricane Rana. She's back up on his shoulders. She spins around to the back. Joey Staplez puts her down. He's got her by the hair. He's hooking her. We haven't seen this move in a while. Free fall through the table. And Katie Dube becomes the first elimination of this lumberyard match as she gets free falled right through the table by Joey Staplez.
You suck.
You suck.
You suck worse. You have people watching me.
Skyler Phoenix and Todd Sople now training punches on the floor. Katie Dube collecting herself and taking her lead from Legacy 2007. Getting an ovation from the fans. So as quickly as it started, we are down to five participants here in this Legacy Lumberyard match. Freakin Flax trying for the toss salad. Gets shoved into the turnbuckle. Saige Zarrello, what's he going to try for here? Freakin Flax goes through the legs of Saige Zarrello. Pokes him right in the eye. What is... Oh, Freakin Flax hits him below the belt. And that's perfectly legal in this one, ladies and gentlemen. No rules, no pinfalls, no submissions, no countouts, no disqualifications. Just put your opponents through the lumber and walk out. The WAW champion, Freakin Flax, trying to pull Zarrello off the apron. Can he do it? Can he get him to fall? Will he? Yes, he will. And Saige Zarrello has been eliminated from the lumberyard match. Neck breaker in the ring by Todd Sople on Joey Staplez. Freakin Flax talking some trash to the guy he just eliminated. Now Freakin Flax conversing with Miss Moody Star on the floor as Todd Sople hit the European uppercut. And two men who are not unfamiliar with each other start going toe-to-toe here, Joey Staplez and Todd Sople. It was at Lord of the Ring that Todd Sople proposed that Staplez and Sople work together when it was in the Final Four, only to have Sople turn his back on Staplez as we had a meeting of the mind of Todd Sople and Joey Staplez. Now we got ourselves a three-way headlock. Skyler Phoenix flies off the top rope and to the floor. Of course, you wouldn't see that he flew from the top rope because our cameraman, for some reason, didn't find it important to shoot up to the top rope when Skyler Phoenix was climbing. Hey, cameraman, next time, catch the top rope, will ya? What, did you have a few drinks with DWI tonight? I'm sure DWI is having themselves quite a few drinks, but not in a celebratory manner, as Chateau Bannigan was defeated earlier tonight by Paul Clement when the Emerald Embassy debuted a new member in the returning Bianca Wild.
I've got feelings.
Y'all people dishonoring.
I guess all those weeks of cheering shatter in the crowd were just a ruse to fool Amanda into thinking she was over there beefs from the past, but clearly she remains a woman scorned as Joey Staplez gives a free fall to Skylar Phoenix on Todd Sople. Freakin Flax now has Joey Staplez in. Toss salad right across Skylar Phoenix's chest. Freakin Flax now up on his feet, as is Todd Sople. He's got him. Blade equalizer. And Freakin Flax hits right across Joey Staplez. I wouldn't be surprised if Freakin Flax might have cracked open Joey Staplez' head or nose, as it looked like Freakin Flax's knee went right across Staplez' face on that landing there. Skylar Phoenix has Sople. And Skyflow drops Todd Sople down right across Freakin Flax. These final four participants are fighting it out, ladies and gentlemen. It is the final four for the WAW Championship. One of these four men are going to walk away with the gold. It could be former WAW champions, Freakin Flax or Todd Sople, or it could be two men who have never held any gold in WAW, and that being Skylar Phoenix and Joey Staplez. What the hell do we have going on here? Skylar Phoenix is up on the top rope. Freakin Flax is in a suplex position. And Todd Sople's at the bottom of the heap, pulling it all down as Freakin Flax hits from the top rope in a quadruple tier falling maneuver there. Freakin Flax got suplexed by Skylar Phoenix, who was powerbombed by Joey Staplez, who was powerbombed by Todd Sople. So essentially, Todd Sople just added a little extra force to the entire thing. And Todd Sople trying to get some work together with Staplez, but he's having no part of it as he hits a free fall by the man who eliminated him from the Lord of the Ring match. Joey Staplez not falling for it this time. Skylar Phoenix now has Joey Staplez send him off with an Irish whip. It's reversed. Staplez catches a punch attempt. He's going for a back suplex. Skylar Phoenix lands on his feet. Skylar Phoenix now going for the Irish whip. Reversed again. Hand broken. Kick blocked. Punch blocked again. Spun around. And we get a skydive. What a sequence there. Both men knew what the other was going to do before they did it and had their hands and feet up to block the respective strikes of their opponent. And now Skylar Phoenix is heading to the outside, and it looks like he could have tables in mind, as he's got one in his hand and he is heading to the ring with that table. Who does he have in mind for the table? As Todd Sople trying to get himself back up, trying to use a piece of that broken table to get up to his feet, as Skylar Phoenix is now setting up a table in the corner. And he could have an elimination in his sight. What is it for Todd Sople, Freakin Flax, or Joey Staplez? And it looks like Skylar Phoenix is going after Joey Staplez. Skylar Phoenix tries for the super kick. It's blocked again. Joey Staplez has Skylar Phoenix going for the T-bone. Skylar Phoenix works his way out. Joey Staplez, let's call him Joey Phoenix. Joey Staplez got charged a clothesline from Southie Miss. And back suplex into the table. And Joey Staplez has been eliminated.
He has brass knuckles. He has brass knuckles. No, no, don't you say it.
Dirty Dealer is irate. Joey Staplez has been eliminated from the Lumberyard match. That's some extra money for the Dealer and Staplez missed out on. You don't get that big legacy bonus check unless you walk away the winner. And that is not something Joey Staplez has done here tonight. And it is now down to the final three. Freakin Flax, Skylar Phoenix, and Todd Sople. Let me get a teacup in the center of the ring. Freakin Flax, Todd Sople, Skylar Phoenix, all going for the teacup rock. Flax now struggling to get back up to his feet. Obvious pain in his lower back there. Todd Sople the next up to his feet. Skylar Phoenix the last man up to his feet. Sople stumbling into a corner. Phoenix down on his back with his feet in the air. Freakin Flax monkey flip right into Sople, who catches Flax, but Flax catches him with a hurricane rana right out of the corner.
Flax!
Flax!
Get the
tuba!
No!
No!
Get the
tuba!
No!
Triceratops?
Freakin Flax trying to make guesses at what Skylar Phoenix wants. But I think it's evident what Skylar Phoenix wants. And there we go. He said he wanted a table. And he is bringing it to the ring. And he has put it up on the ring apron. And Freakin Flax is now grabbing that table.
Flax always has wood.
Trying to set it up here. Skylar Phoenix now coming back into the ring. Todd Sople crawling around, looking to avoid any sort of attack from Skylar Phoenix or Todd, excuse me, or Freakin Flax. Sople could be about to be put through a table in his legacy dreams of becoming WAW champion once again. Will be put to rest. And Freakin Flax now is heading up to the top rope. Oh, wait a second, Skylar Phoenix just got kicked in the mouth. And oh! Oh, the table game before Sople had a chance to go through it. Looks like somebody needs to lay off the hamburgers. Todd Sople now up in the corner with Freakin Flax coming out of the corner after crashing through that table. And for those of you wondering at home, yes, that does not count. Sople putting himself through a table does not eliminate him from this contest. Freakin Flax now up on the top rope.
Another one? As long as he doesn't break it.
What's he gonna go for here? Kick to the side of the head from Skylar Phoenix. It's Freakin Flax gets hung up on the top rope once again. Punch to the face of Skylar Phoenix. Drops the unbreakable. And Phoenix thrown over the top rope and out to the floor. And Todd Sople now setting up a table. Freakin Flax hit crotch first on that top turnbuckle. What could he have in mind here? Todd Sople is heading up to the top rope. He's got Freakin Flax. What is he gonna do here? Gonna be going for an overhead suplex. He's got him set up. Overhead suplex. Sople falls over the table, but Freakin Flax went through with the overhead suplex. And we have got broken tables everywhere. Ain't just two men left standing, Skylar Phoenix and Todd Sople. One of these men walk away the new WAW champion. Sople clearing the debris.
You okay, Lex?
Skylar Phoenix collecting himself, and it is now time for these two men to do battle. Freakin Flax leaving Legacy 2007, just short of becoming WAW champion for a second time. Skylar Phoenix takes a swing and tells Sople to shut up. And here we go. It's the final two. Irish whip by Todd Sople sends him off the opposite side. Phoenix ducks the clothesline. And a flying shoulder block by Skylar Phoenix takes down the equalizer. These two men have been embroiled in a bitter grudge since Annihilation last year. And it is coming to a fever pitch right here tonight as the WAW Championship is on the line. And Todd Sople catches a super kick right to the jaw from Skylar Phoenix.
Come on, get a table!
Phoenix now going for a table.
These tables are heavy.
He could have elimination once again in his mind. He's already been responsible for the elimination of Joey Staplez. He looks to be responsible for the elimination of Todd Sople, the retaining of his legacy championship and the winning of the WAW championship. Sople's out on the apron, as is Skylar Phoenix. Both men fighting here. Both men wanting to walk out the WAW champion. Todd Sople is on the apron. Skylar Phoenix is up on the middle rope, going for the overcastle, but instead goes through back first through that table, landing on his tailbone on the floor. That does not count, ladies and gentlemen. Skylar Phoenix put himself through the board. Todd Sople merely moved out of the way. And Todd Sople now grabbing that table, heading towards the ring with it. Rolling that table into the ring is Todd Sople, and he could be looking to wrap this one up as Skylar Phoenix just crashed through a table of his own doing, jumping off, trying for the overcastle, and instead was met with a back full of table instead of being met with the WAW championship. Note to Sople, don't sit on this one. Sople lining up that table with careful physics. Looked like he was positioning it inch for inch, centimeter for centimeter on that one. But Todd Sople now, he's got Skylar Phoenix up on the top rope, and this could be all for the unbreakable Skylar Phoenix. He has fought hard and valiantly thus far, but I think going through the table there put him at a serious disadvantage, as Todd Sople now gonna try and go for a back suplex, but Skylar Phoenix is fighting out of it. He's fighting hard, trying to avoid the back suplex. Skylar Phoenix, he's on the top rope, he pushes off, he goes through, and she rings the bell, she calls for it. Skylar Phoenix is the new WAW champion. Skylar Phoenix pushed off the top rope there before Todd Sople started pulling, thus making it an offensive move for Skylar Phoenix, and a man whose career started in November of 2004 with WAW. Just under 3 years later, here on the biggest stage that WAW has to offer each year, Skylar Phoenix, once known as Skyy, then known as the Skyy, then he took on his real, true name, Skylar Phoenix, last year, the man with many names throughout his WAW career, is now the WAW champion here at Legacy 2007. What a moment, what a thrill for Skylar Phoenix, not only walking away WAW champion, not only keeping his legacy title, but doing it against Todd Sople, a man who has been a thorn in his side for close to a year now. Skylar Phoenix is your 2007 Legacy Champion, and he is the new WAW Champion. Oh, what a victory, and oh, what a night here at Legacy 2007. What a night it has been here at Legacy, ladies and gentlemen, the sixth annual. We started this night off with Current defeating Full Metal Jacket in a two-on-one handicap match. We continued the night with the return of Bianca Wild, joining the Evil Embassy, helping Paul Clement defeat Shots O'Banigan. We saw Christian Zane and Gino Diomedes battle it out for 30 minutes, where through hook or crook, Christian Zane walked away the Iron Man. We saw the first ever I Quit match, where Epo continued his legacy dominance, becoming 5-0 and sending Sin packing for 6 months. We saw Asylum and Total Chaos battle it out in a ladder match, where Asylum continued their one-year reign as WAW team champions. And we saw that man right there taking his lead, Skylar Phoenix, walk away here tonight with the WAW championship. And there you see right there, Todd Sople, realizing he was just inches away from the WAW Championship. What a night it has been here at Legacy. We would like to thank all of you great fans who came out and supported the JTA Baseball Fund Charity Collections. You have no idea how much your continued support means to WAW, and we hope that you will join us in just 1 week's time as we start the road to annihilation with Aftermath. Thank you for joining us, and good night.